Chair.
Yeah, honorable members.
Sir, please.
Please press the last button, whatever you haven't. If there's anybody who hasn't here.
Deputy Speaker.
Yes, honorable member.
Deputy Speaker, I think there's been a confusion from your announcement that side. It was not clear. Are you saying those in favor will press the green button and those against will press the red?
That's no, honorable chair, okay. This is the first time I ever had this confusion in this house. No, honorable members, please, you can't be confused by pressing the green button when we are asked to approve this thing. Absolutely, yeah, no. No. Honorable members, we are finished. No, honorable members, I will not comment on what I think is happening here. Let me read this thing again. Honorable members, you should press the yes button to record your support for the recommendation. Is that clear? Those not in favor, nomination, press the no button. And those wishing to abstain should press the abstain button. I'm assuming that you have all voted. Yes, honorable member?
Deputy Speaker, there are three names on that list.
Sorry? So
yes. There are three names on that list.
Yeah.
So if we object to two of them, then we're going to have to let the other one object to the other one as well. Can't we do them individually instead?
No.
I mean, there's one good person amongst it, two rotten people.
Honorable member.
Now he's also going to suffer.
No, honorable member. You should have intervened even before the voting process.
No, but I thought you'd be able to think this for yourself.
No. Honorable member, there's no provision for that option.
No, this is illogical.
Yes.
No, it's very
in
logical.
Your opinion,
what you're doing,
it's illogical.
No, what you're doing is very logical. There are three people there. We object to two. The other one is okay. But now we have to object to all three for one vote. Because these people want to go home. No, we got to do one at a time.
No. Honorable member.
No. I'm helping you here.
Okay.
Deputy Speaker, I'm helping you here. You can't do this. It's illogical. It doesn't make sense.
Honorable member, thank you very much. Your opinion is absolutely rich. I'm afraid I don't accept
it. No, but you can't dismiss me like this.
No, I'm not accepting it, honorable member. And in any case, the voting is complete.
No, but
so
it's wrong.
Take your seat.
What you're doing is wrong.
Okay. That's fine. That's your opinion, honorable member.
No, this is extremely arrogant of you, Deputy Speaker.
Honorable member, you are now getting out of order. You are now quarreling with the chair of the house. You are out of order. Take your seat, honorable member. You are projecting, actually. You seem to assume your opinions are right every time. That's inappropriate, honorable member.
Deputy Speaker, just on a point of order.
Yes.
Deputy Speaker. Is it parliamentary for the honorable member to say a presiding officer is arrogant? If not, he must withdraw the word arrogant.
No, honorable member, I have said what I said. Honorable Paulson, I plead with you to take your seat so that we proceed with the announcement of the results of the voting. The voting session is closed. We will now request the people in front of us here to let us know how you voted.